He is the All-American, Chris Weidman, 9-0 in his mixed martial arts career. A two-time Division I All-American wrestler at Hofstra, a two-time junior college All-American, Grappler's Quest champion, longtime student of Ray Longo and Matt Serra. And they told both you and I, when he first burst on the scene, watch for this kid, because he is something special.
I've never heard Matt Serra give someone as much praise as I've heard him give Chris Weidman. The way he talks about this guy, the way this guy performs in the training room, and the performances that we've seen inside the octagon have indicated this is a special athlete.
And also, he's very confident coming in, something you talked about in the open of the show. So many men, before they walk through that gate, have already been defeated by Anderson Silva. Chris Weidman says, that's not the case with me.
Whether or not that confidence makes any sense, we're gonna find out in about 10 minutes.
Yes, we are.
But I'll tell you this, what we've seen from him inside the octagon is exceptional. What we've seen from him in the training room is even more exceptional. He believes that his best is yet to come. And the conventional wisdom is that if Anderson Silva wanted to fight Chris Weidman, now's the time instead of a year from now.
Yes.
Because he's getting better every minute of every day. And at 29 years of age, he's a young man. And at 38 years of age, one of the things you have to think about with a great champion like Anderson Silva is, when does father time catch up with him?
Could it be tonight? We will find out as Chris Weidman gets the opportunity he has been very patiently waiting for, the opportunity to be a UFC champion.
And there are special all-stars who are better than the rest, but very few times do we truly see what we see with Anderson Silva, somebody who does things that no one else does in his particular sport.
He's just the best mixed martial arts fighter I've ever seen in my life, and I've seen the greatest fights of all time, live, in person. This is the best. It's such an honor to be able to watch this guy fight, because what we're seeing is, you and I have been working for the UFC for a long time, and one of the things that we've seen is a massive evolution of the martial arts itself. This is the best example of that. He is the best example of what is possible. What is possible in the 21st century with modern training techniques and all the knowledge that's been accumulated all over the years? That's the best. He's the fastest, he's got the most accurate strikes, he's got the most well-rounded game, he takes the least amount of damage, and he has had the most spectacular results.
16-0 inside the octagon. 9 men have failed to bring down the champion at 185. The list of records is long.
the title defenses. He's going for number 11, a UFC record here tonight. But it's what he does and how he does it. That's what makes watching Anderson Silva fight so truly fascinating.
His highlight reel is like no one else's. Yes. And it's against elite fighters like Vitor Belfort, spectacular front kick knockout to the face. The way he took out Chael Sonnen in their second fight. The way he stopped Stefan Bonner in Brazil. The way he crushed James Irvin and Forrest Griffin. He's just a really special athlete, and it's just a real treat to get a chance to see a guy like this fight inside the octagon.
11-0 in championship fights. The middleweight title last changed hands in October of 2006 when Anderson Silva defeated Rich Franklin. A UFC record 12 post-fight bonuses. He won the belt in his second UFC fight. He brings it in the octagon with him tonight. He plans on leaving with it around his waist. He is the champion, the greatest, Anderson the Spider Silva. Tail of the tape for this, our main event of the evening. Silva, 38 years old, as Joe mentioned. Chris Weidman, just 29 years old. Everything else is virtually identical. With the official introductions, once again, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. Sanctioned by the Nevada State Athletic Commission, with Chairman Bill Brady, Executive Director Keith Kaiser, Commissioners Francisco Aguilar, Skip Avancino, TJ Day, and Pat Lundball. Our three judges scoring this contest at Octagon Side are Marcos Rosales, Adelaide Bird, and Patricia Morse-Jarman. When the action begins, our referee in charge of the Octagon, Herb Dean. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for.
Good morning, everybody. How are you? Thanks for waiting around. Sorry we're late. So this year for the UFC, this has been the greatest end of a year we've ever had. We had the Pettis fight in Henderson. We just had Jones versus Gustafsson. We have Cain Velasquez versus Junior Dos Santos coming up in October in Houston. We got GSP versus Johnny Hendricks right here at the MGM. And we are ending the year with Ronda Rousey, Miesha Tate, and Chris Weidman and Anderson Silva. Who has the first question? Raise their hand. They'll give you a microphone.
For Chris, please. Chris, how many times have you had a chance to go back and watch the fight since the first fight? How many times have you watched it over and over?
I watched it, I can't tell you how many times, but a bunch of times, probably the first 2 weeks after the fight, and I haven't really watched it since, but a lot of times. I don't know, maybe 50. I'll throw that out there.
And when you watch the fight, what's your evaluation of it? You know, is it a mistake that he made or a perfect performance by you? What is your evaluation of the fight?
You know, I think I went out there and worked hard and went for everything that I felt. You know, in the first round, I went for the heel hook and knee bar. You know, didn't get it, but I went for it. You know, I felt a little sluggish in there. You know, I had a year off. I had two back-to-back surgeries. So I didn't feel 100%, but I still, you know, felt good enough to get the win. And I'm excited to have a full camp and be able to, you know, not have to nurse an injury, and excited for this next fight.
And so much of the talk afterwards, it seemed like immediately, was about what Anderson did wrong versus what you did right. Did that frustrate you at all, or did you kind of expect that that was going to be the public reaction?
No, I didn't mind at all. You know, he deserves that type of respect. He's, you know, greatest of all time. People can't fathom the fact that he lost. So, obviously, I knew going into that fight we were going to have a rematch. I was going to have to prove people wrong again. Even after this next fight, when I win, there's still going to be a lot of doubters out there. There's always going to be excuses out there for, you know, why you got the W, and that's just part of the sport.
And for Anderson, if I could, please, I'm curious, Anderson, how many times has he watched the fight since it first happened, and what his evaluation was? Was it just a fantastic performance by Chris, or does he feel like he made a mistake?
So I'm watching the fight in the three times. My coach watching more.
And what's your thought when you watch it? Was it just an amazing performance by Chris, or was it just a mistake by you?
The Chris is new champion, man. You need to respect this guy, bro. Come on.
And one last one, Anderson. Before the fight, you mentioned, you know, the pressures of being a champion and how difficult it was. Has there been any positives in not being a champion? Has life been any easier or less pressure-filled for you?
Nope.
Hello. My first question is for Anderson. During the fight, Chris was able to take you down right away in the beginning. How much have you worked on your wrestling or takedown defense preparing for this fight?
I trained the Grandmaster Jedi now. Yeah, Yoda.
And what was the reaction from the Brazilian home crowd when you came home and for the first time you didn't have the belt?
Normal. I'm Brazilian. It's normal.
And for you, Chris, what has changed for you since you've been the champion?
A lot of different people coming out of the woodwork, for sure. You know, I was able to get out of the house. I got hit by Hurricane Sandy, able to buy a new house, going into closing soon. So that's going to be huge, be able to be organized, not clustered up into a, you know, a small little house. So I'm excited to have that. I think that's, I don't know, there's probably some different things, but that's all I'm thinking of right now.
And ahead of this fight that's coming up, how important is it for you to not just get a win, but to try to finish Anderson again?
You know, very important. I want to go out there and shine. Obviously, there's a lot of doubters out there. You know, but the biggest thing for me is just to train every, you know, win every single day. You know, it doesn't just start when I walk into that cage. Every day I got to train as hard as I can, and then go out there and just go as hard as I can. Any type of instincts that I'm feeling at the time, I got to go for it. Otherwise, I'm going to have regrets, and I'm going to be going for the finish the whole time. That's just the way I fight.
And just one last question for you. You had mentioned that you felt sluggish in the last fight, not 100% from the shoulder. If this fight were to go five rounds, do you feel that rust has been shaken off? And do you feel that you would have the durability to last the entire fight this time around?
Yeah, no, I was prepared to go five rounds in the last fight. I didn't necessarily feel tired. I just felt a little, you know, off. I felt a little sluggish, a little slower. But, you know, I'm also going against Anderson Silva, who's fast and quick. So, I mean, it could be a combination of that. But
Dana, this is for you. Initially, when you saw the fight, you had feelings about it. Now time has passed. Do you look at it any different, or have your feelings changed about how it ended now as opposed to when it initially ended?
No, this was one of those fights where people were talking about this fight a month after. I mean, the buzz about this fight was huge. And, I, you know, obviously I'm up here, we're promoting the fight, but I'm telling you, we've got a great end of the year, tons of amazing fights. The fights that just happened last Saturday with Jones and Gustafsson was awesome, one of the most exciting fights I've been to in a long time. And I'm honestly, when I say this, I mean it, I can't wait for this fight. This is one of those fights that, how the first one ended, you know, there were a lot of questions with Anderson's age and everything else. Anderson didn't look old. Anderson didn't look like he didn't belong in there. Weidman came out and did what he did. When the music plays and these guys are walking out December 28th and they start to come toward the octagon and they get in there, I don't know if I've been this excited for a fight ever in the UFC. I can't wait for this rematch.
A couple questions for Chris, please.
How's it going?
What have you heard more of after that fight? Have you heard more praise for you being the first person to knock off Anderson, or more doubt because of kind of the way it happened with him kind of toying around in the cage?
I think it changed. In the beginning, there was a lot of praise, and then a lot of the doubters, you know, came out. I think I see a lot of that now. You know, I send a tweet, and then I get hit up with a million people. You get to die next fight. Angry Anderson Silva is going to come out and smoke you. You know, you stink. You know, so I see a lot of that right now. But you know, that's all good. That's what makes this sport awesome. Whether they're rooting for Anderson Silva or me, I love the fans. You know, he deserves all the credit in the world. I mean, he's been doing this so much longer than me. He's done so much for the sport. He's had crazy finishes in his time, and he deserves all that, no matter if he gets knocked out or not.
I know you said the doubt doesn't bother you, but kind of how do you handle it? I mean, do you use it as motivation, or do you just kind of ignore it altogether?
I have a lot of motivation just stemming from myself and different things, you know, family and other things like that. But definitely, it motivates me. You know, I want to prove people wrong. I like being the underdog. I like having that feeling where people think I'm going to lose and I've proven wrong.
And one question for Anderson, please. Anderson, last time we saw you here in Vegas after the fight, you said you didn't want to fight for the belt anymore. You weren't interested in a rematch. What changed your mind?
So I have the new contract. In my contract, I have 9 more fights.
That's it? Nothing else?
Yeah.
His new contract's pretty motivating.
Anderson, qual sua maior motivação para essa luta?
My family, my team, and my fans.
Anderson, você pode falar um pouquinho sobre a pressão? Antes você reclamou muito da pressão que você sofreu em função de ser o campeão e de ficar tanto tempo, né, com essa pressão de sempre ser o melhor. Depois que você perdeu o cinturão, qual é a pressão mais difícil de lidar? É a pressão de ter perdido o cinturão e de ter que lidar com as críticas? Ou é a pressão de ser o campeão e ter que ser sempre o melhor?
She said, it seems like you had a lot of pressure when you were champion, but I want to find out from you, is there more pressure now that you're not champion, or was there more pressure when you were champion?
Give people a little more. They want to hear more.
So, I don't have more pressure now because Chris is a new champion. Huh? I'm working hard for back the belt for me in Brazil, but I don't have more pressure.
Does it feel better now?
What
does it
say?
Feel better now that you have the pressure?
Yeah, I'm very happy.
And Chris, are you going to change something for your training, I mean for this fight, or are you going to keep the same strategy?
No, pretty much same strategy. The only difference is around this time, before the last fight, I was still, you know, nursing an injury and I wasn't able to improve. And right now I'm able to still work out and improve every day. So. That's really the only difference. As far as strategy, it's kind of the same for every one of my fights. Just, you know, walk forward and I try, you know, to see. It's a chess game out there. You know, if he thinks I'm doing one thing, I'm going to do the other.
For Chris, right here. Don't take this the wrong way. I don't want to suggest at all that any win over Anderson Silva is easy. But I wonder, like, after the fight, just the way it went, was there any thought that went through your mind, like, wow, that was not as difficult as I thought it was going to be?
No, it was difficult. I'm not saying it was easy. You know, he's as good as everybody thinks he is. You know, he's known as the greatest of all time for a reason. It's no fluke. You know, he's a stud, and I'm expecting a war in the next fight, and you know, I'm hoping for a finish.
Yeah, this question is usually asked of the loser of these types of fights, but what was the biggest thing that you learned about Anderson? Obviously, you were prepared for him, and you watched a lot of film on him, but actually being in the cage with him, what was the biggest thing you learned from that experience?
What did I learn? You know, he threw leg kicks. I didn't expect him to throw leg kicks as much. We didn't really train for that. The one guy in my camp who throws a lot of leg kicks was, he had a shin issue, so I didn't really get leg kicked during the camp. I expected him to be a little bit more nervous of the takedowns with that. So I think that's the one thing that I was like, all right, I got to start checking these leg kicks. But besides that, you know, I expected him to be awesome, and he is.
And just one question for you, Anderson. It seems like you don't feel like Chris is getting the respect he deserves. I've seen you say that to several reporters over the last few months, that, you know, respect this guy as the champion. Why don't you think that he's getting the respect? Is it stories that you've read, or why do you keep saying that?
I don't know. But sometimes the people watching the UFC, the older people like UFC, but no respect the champion. The Chris is new champion. The people need to respect this guy because the guy killed me. It's normal. This is the champion, guys. I need your respect. Thank you.
Dana, just one question for you. You gave media members some crap about their pound for pound rankings when we were in Toronto. I'm just wondering, like, can you name your top five pound for pound? I guess it's been a while since we've really gotten your overlook of what the pound for pound rankings look like, and you got two guys who might be in there right now.
Yeah. You know, Chris Weidman, I don't want to not respect him. Anderson just said to respect him, but I wouldn't catapult him into the top five with one win over, even though it's a huge win. But I would still have my top five, John Jones, Anderson Silva, GSP. I'm telling you, Henan Barão is in there somewhere. Henan Barão has won 21 fights in a row, hasn't lost in over 8 years. And does it spectacularly. All those in there, you know, just off the top of my head. John?
Chris, obviously in the build-up to the first fight, you were super respectful. You're being very respectful now. But you did have that outburst of emotion after the victory where you screamed a little bit of expletives there and that sort of thing. Was that just, you know, a moment that happened that kind of surprised even you that it came out, or was that something that you were kind of holding on to and keeping underneath the surface all the time?
Oh, no. It kind of just came out in that fight. I got to the point where, you know, he was taunting me, which we expected, and we had guys doing during the camp. But I felt like he was excessive with it to the point where I felt like he was excessive for not really doing any damage to me. And I'm just like, you know, what are you doing? And I just got to the point I was like, you know, I got frustrated and I just wanted to hit him.
Ultimately, that kind of seemed to have worked out in your favor. So the second time around, is that something you try to stay away from and keep that emotion out of it? Or does it, you know, did that end up being kind of a helping factor for you?
I mean, it helped in this fight. So I don't know. I can't control, the way I'm going to feel in the octagon next time. I can't control what he's going to do. But I'm just going to go off my instincts. And at the time, I just felt like it was the right thing to do to move in on him. I know he was trying to fake like I didn't hurt him on one of the shots. And Or he was faking that I hurt him. And I just felt like it was the right time. I felt like I would catch him off guard, and I just sprung in there and went for it.
Thanks. And for Anderson, please, so much was made of the interviews he gave, but in the week to the fight and how he was acting, and it seemed a little bizarre. First, was there any connection between his behavior and the performance, and does he have any regrets at all for how he handled himself in the week before the fight? Anderson, you know, there was a lot made of like his interviews and saying Chris Weidman would be the champ. Does he have any regrets that he handled that way and wasn't connected at all?
No. Why? Sometimes I'm joker. It's normal.
And is there any feeling now? I know you have 9 fights left on a contract, but is there any feeling at all that this fight could determine the rest of your future? That if you don't win this fight, there's nothing left for you.
So, I have 9 more fights. And my focus is my rematch for Chris. And the new Anders is come, bro. Trust me.
All right, you guys good? You want to start asking fan questions? You want to add them?
For Chris, last time you went into the fight, I know you believed you were going to win, but not that many people believed in you, and you kind of flew under the radar like most of Anderson's opponents. Do you feel that you kind of lost that advantage going into this, that, you know, now you're the champion and you don't really have that ability to fly under the radar like you did before?
Well, I'm kind of still flying under the radar. You know, a lot of people still think, you know, he was playing around last fight. This time he's not going to play around, and I'm in big trouble. So there's a lot of people like that. But no, I haven't really even thought of that, to be honest with you. I still have the support group I have around me. That's all I really, focus on. I got a great family. I got great coaches, great fans, and that's where my focus is as far as support.
And all the other things that come with being a champion, I mean, parades and appearing at, football games like we saw the other day. Have you been able to kind of compartmentalize maybe that stuff and say, I have this stuff, but I also have to get ready for a fight still? It's, kind of a balance you have to find as champion.
Yeah, I'm not a great multitasker. I only focus on one thing at a time. So that stuff is just kind of, it's not even a focus at all. I'm just very focused on this next fight, and that's really it.
All right, let's take the mic around to some of the fans. And want to start back there? Go ahead, honey. What do you got?
Anybody want to ask? Oi, Anderson. Woo! É o Brasil aqui torcendo para você. A gente está muito na expectativa muito grande da próxima luta. Como que estão seus treinos para a próxima luta?
Estão bem legais. Eu estou treinando bastante. Estou bem focado, feliz de poder lutar mais uma vez, de poder tentar recuperar o cinturão.
O Brasil te ama, viu?
Obrigado.
Estamos torcendo junto com você.
Obrigado.
Yeah, that was his longest answer of the day. We got to know what he said there.
Yeah, she said that Brazil loves you, Brazil's behind you, and we want to know how your training has been for this fight. And he answered that my training's been going well. I'm very excited to go out there and bring my belt back. And then she answered back, Brazil loves you.
Weidman said, Jesus Christ, did all the Brazilians fly in for this press conference? Who's got the next question?
Speaking of Jesus Christ, Chris, you seem very humble and very grounded and very appreciative of what you've done. And you mentioned God in the ring. Is your faith a big part of your confidence and your calmness in the ring?
100%. It all stems from that. God gave me these gifts, and I'm just trying every day to work as hard as I possibly can with them. And then before I'm walking to that cage, I just say a prayer and put it all into his hands. All I have control over is how hard I work in that cage. The rest is going to be up to God and his plan. So it takes the pressure off me. It's all on him.
The question is for Anderson.
Yeah, go ahead, buddy. Right here.
Got it. Okay. My question is, I know that in the past you were much better than your opponents, and you were playing with them. And this playing with your opponents didn't work very well in the last fight. Are you have any regrets of doing that? Are you planning on keeping the same style?
No, this is my style, and I'm working hard for a long time in UFC. I have the great fights in here. It's the same position and the same style. I don't change nothing.
Hey, this question is for Chris. Certainly all respect to Anderson Silva, the greatest of all time. Chris, as you prepare for the rematch, you gonna bring anybody else into the camp to work on a new wrinkle or new approach to your strategy against Anderson?
As far as right now, we have no plans to bring anybody too different than from last camp. We had some guys, Steven Wonderboy Thompson, who fought this past weekend. He came in, he has some great kicks and some unorthodox stuff that Anderson does. He's a fast guy on his feet. So we brought him in last time. We had some Muay Thai kickboxers, some Olympic level boxers we brought in. So we brought in some really good guys just from almost the New York area, a couple other places, but nothing else really.
Okay. Hello, Anderson. Here. E aí, beleza? Todo mundo criticou muito, falou falta de humildade E só que assim, você tem uma ginga brasileira ali na hora de lutar. E aí eu queria saber se isso realmente é... Você fala que é o seu estilo de luta, mas faz, você faz um personagem ali na hora também?
Não, ali não dá pra fazer personagem, não. Ali dentro o negócio é sério. É... Assim, logo depois da luta, eu recebi várias críticas de várias pessoas, mas é que eu entendo até porque ninguém sobe lá pra lutar, né? Ninguém treina 4 meses e sabe o que, que a gente passa. Eu não treinei 4 meses pra ir lá e tomar um soco e perder. Eu cometi um erro que foi ficar com as pernas paralelas e que está sendo corrigido. Fora isso, eu vou continuar fazendo o que eu sempre fiz.
Você vai mostrar quem manda, né?
Bom, quem manda é um homem lá em cima, né? Então, eu vou esperar, vou treinar forte, como sempre, e vou tentar vencer de novo.
She basically said that, you know, a lot of people, you know, criticize, you know, after the fight, how you were playing around. Do you think that that's really your style of fighting, or is it part of your personality? And he said, no, there's nothing about my personality in there. I go in there and I fight, and I committed an error, and my error was is that I stopped with my feet parallel to each other, which is being fixed right now, and he took advantage of that position. And then she said, so that does that mean that you're going to run things now? And he said, I don't run things. It's the man upstairs that runs everything.
Anderson. Anderson, aqui. Anderson. Anderson Silva.
Yeah.
Aqui. Quando você perdeu, você falou que não sabia se ia ter revanche, você estava feliz, como você disse agora, está feliz, está tranquilo, sem pressão nas costas. O que está te fazendo fazer revanche? O careca aí que está mandando? Ou, porque se você ganhar, vai voltar tudo de novo.
He said after the fight, you mentioned about the rematch, you know, you mentioned about the rematch that you didn't want it, that you felt there was a lot of pressure off your back. What made you change? And he said, was it the bald guy that made you change?
Então, vai começar tudo de novo, cara. Eu vou ter que... Vai começar tudo de novo. Vai ser aquela loucura tudo de novo. Então, faz parte, né, do trabalho. Eu amo fazer isso, né? Quando eu comecei a treinar, eu nunca pensei que ia chegar onde eu cheguei hoje. Eu sempre achei que eu ia ser tão bom quanto os meus professores. Eu ia dar aula e etc. Mas Deus me trouxe para esse caminho. Então, eu tenho que aproveitar e o que foi bom eu ter perdido para entender o quanto Deus foi importante na minha vida durante todo esse tempo, né? E ele me deu um presente ao qual eu, de certa forma, esqueci um pouco disso, né? Que é o título de ser campeão e tal. Mas agora eu entendi como é que funciona, né? A gente está sempre aprendendo e eu entendi bem. E agora, com certeza, muita coisa vai mudar.
He said, you know, I love what I do, and, you know, and I've always loved what I did, but when I started training, I never imagined that I would get to the point that I'm at today. I always imagined that, you know, I would hopefully be as good as my instructors and be able to teach class, but, you know, I never thought that I was going to have the success that I've had being the UFC champion, and I think God really helps me and teaches you all the time, and I realized that I didn't appreciate or I didn't value what I had. And I can tell you that now God works in mysterious ways, and now I realize what I had, and I'm going to focus to go back and get what I had.
Cool. Go ahead.
Anderson. Aqui direto da Bahia.
Liga lá, bichinha. Oxente.
Yes. Muito acarajé e pimenta.
Oxi.
Eu, como todos os brasileiros, fiquei muito desapontada. Lógico, isso aqui está sendo repetido várias vezes.
Me xingou na internet também?
Com certeza. Na verdade, eu não quero fazer uma pergunta. Eu quero te fazer um pedido.
Diga lá, vai.
Ganhe. Derruba esse cara no primeiro round.
She basically said, she says, like a lot of the Brazilians, she said, you know, I was pretty upset with what happened. And then Anderson says, were you one of the people that cussed me out on the internet? And he said, yeah. And she says, I don't really have a question. I'm asking you a favor, and that's to go out there and knock this guy out in the first round.
Eu vou tentar, tá bom? I try. Promise.
Chris, what's your prediction for the final result of the rematch?
You know, that's what's great about this sport. I have no idea. You know, I have no idea what's going to happen in there. I'm going to finish. He's obviously going to be going for the finish. It's going to be a crazy fight. We're both winners. We both want to win. That's what's going to make this fight awesome. I have no idea. I got no inside information for you. Whether it's a submission, knockout, TKO, no idea.
We'll take a couple more. Anybody? No? Nobody got any? Over here? Right here, honey. What do you got? Give her a mic. Yeah. Oh, now no? Scared you? All right. Sorry. Is that it? You guys got anything else? We good? Thanks for coming, everybody. We appreciate you. We'll see you December 28th. So I'm going to square these guys off up here so you can get some pictures.
Weidman is the UFC middleweight champion.
The way